Now, you all know that what do we mean by soil? As you all know that what is a natural resource? So one of the natural resources is soil also, because we know that we feed on, we need food to live, and we get food from plants, and plants need soil for their growth. So that means soil is again a natural resource. So what is soil actually? It is the uppermost layer of earth crust. It is the uppermost layer of the earth crust. And now for what purpose the soil is being used? It is a home for many microorganisms and many insects. As you can see, there are many organisms that actually live in the soil. So that is the habitat for them. Moreover, they provide nutrient to plants, because plant needs certain kind of nutrients which are already in soil, and if the plant will get that nutrient, then only they can photosynthesize or grow, and if they will photosynthesize or make food, then only we'll get to eat. So obviously, directly or indirectly, we are also dependent on soil, and it anchors the plant, that means it holds the plant. So now, what is topsoil? So soil have different regions. So topsoil is the most important layer. It is actually the uppermost layer of the soil, and it is actually called as a fertile layer. It is the uppermost layer, and it is a fertile layer because it contains the organic matter. It is rich in nutrients, and it contains an organic matter that is the humus, which make a soil efficient for the growth of plants. Now, due to many activities, there can be a loss of topsoil, and loss of topsoil is called as soil erosion. So sometimes the topsoil is being carried away by wind, water, etc. So removal of topsoil due to any factor like wind, water, etc. is just called as soil erosion, and that is very harmful. So what are the factors that can actually erode soil? One is the deforestation. We know that with modernization, we are just cutting trees, cutting down trees due to for fulfilling many needs of the industries and all. So we know that whenever there is a plant in the soil, the plants try to hold the soil firmly. So if when there will be no plants, like when we'll cut the plants, so there will be no plant there, and the soil will be left free. So that kind of soil can actually be easily carried by the wind and water, because it becomes loose. So that means deforestation can be a major factor. And we know that suppose we keep on using the soil again and again, we are using the soil again and again, and it becomes the time will come when it will become deficient in nutrients, and when it will become deficient in nutrients, you won't use that soil for the growth of the plants. So if you won't use that soil for the growth of the plants, so that means again the soil will be loose, and it can be easily carried away by the wind or water. So that means deforestation, cutting down trees or plants for your personal, for satisfying other needs, is a you can say major reason. And excess plantation is again a major reason, because in this, when the soil will become infertile, it won't be suitable for growth of plants, and you won't use that, and the plant the soil will be not be held by plants firmly, so and they can be easily taken away by wind and water. Third, so that means these are the factors, the major factor which can actually leads to soil erosion. And as you know that soil is very important, as we have done that we need food also, it is a habitat for microorganisms and organisms also. So we need to conserve soil. So the practice of conserving the topsoil is called as soil conservation. The practice of conserving the topsoil is called as soil conservation. How you can do it? By afforestation. Obviously, deforestation led to soil erosion. So afforestation can control soil erosion up to a large amount, because afforestation means planting more trees, and when you will plant more trees, they will try to hold the soil, and the soil will not be free, that it can be easily carried by wind or water. So that means afforestation should be practiced if you need to prevent the soil erosion. Secondly, by wind breakers and shelf breakers, we can actually prevent soil erosions. What is that? Suppose after harvesting, when your land becomes free, try to plant trees and small shrubs in rows of one or two, because if you try to plant those trees or shrubs there, they will try to hold the soil, and they are actually called as wind breakers, or they are called as shelf breakers, because they can actually prevent the soil erosion. So this you can do, like whenever your land becomes free, try to plant shrubs in row of one or two, it will just try to hold the soil. Third, you can practice crop rotation. What is crop rotation? Crop rotation is a practice of growing crops alternatively For example, suppose if I'm growing a crop, a certain kind of crop in the soil which require nitrogen. So there will be a time, the time will come when the soil will become deficient in the nitrogen. So what should I do in order to make my keep my soil fertile? I should grow something other than that in my soil which do not need nitrogen. Suppose you grow, I'll explain you again. Suppose I have this soil. Right. I grow this thing, a crop A, which needs nitrogen. So just grow it. Then when you harvest this crop, do not grow crop A again. Alternate with some other crop. Let's say I'm alternating with the leguminous plants. And we know that leguminous plants have a special bacteria, that is rhizobium. We have already discussed also in nutrition of plants that there's a leguminous plants contain rhizobium bacteria which is capable of converting the atmospheric nitrogen into nitrogen compounds. So first, when you're growing a crop, it will make the nitrogen content less. So in the when you harvest it, then the plant crop B, because when you'll plant crop B, they don't require nitrogen. Instead, they will form the nitrogen and will add nitrogen to the soil. So in that way, they will increase the fertility of the soil. And if the soil will be fertile, as I told you, it will be better for the vegetation, and we'll grow plants there. And when we will grow plants there, it will hold the soil tightly. And when it will hold the soil, it will less prone to erosion. So this you can do actually. Moreover, we can do terrace farming and step farming also. This occur mainly in the hilly regions. So when in the hilly regions, whenever there are rains or something, they can actually take away the topsoil. So what we do there, we just make the steps. Like when we do the farming, we do in stepwise. We make a series of steps like stairs, you can say. So that is called a step farming. So when you do step farming, they will make the passage for the flow of water, and the soil erosion is prevented. Sometimes in hilly areas, what we do, we just try to make the walls of concrete and stones around the farm so that they can actually prevent the soil erosion. This also we can do. So these are the four major factors which you can actually practice in order to conserve soil. Plant more trees. When you harvest the crop, try to plant trees and shrubs. Crop rotation in order to increase the fertility, and terrace farming or step farming, it is done in the hilly areas. That is, the farming is done in stepwise, so that form a channel for the flow of water, and it is preventing the soil erosion. So that means soil is very important, and you can just prevent the soil erosion, as it is serving many important use, and directly or indirectly even we are dependent on plants, and plants depend upon soil. So this you can do it, and in order to prevent our natural resource, that is the soil, which is very important.